there. You call me. And Gyani. Gyani also they say. Gyani, the scientists, they are Gyani. That what is the use of worshipping God? Let us study the laws of God. So Gyani and Karmi and Yogi, they are also of the same view. So Karmi, Gyani, Yogi, and the last is Bhakta. So Bhakta can see God very quickly. Because Krishna recommends, Bhaktya mam abhijanati javana jasyami tattata. Tattata, in truth, one can understand what is God by following the process of bhakti yoga. And so far the jnanis, yogis are concerned, they will come to that point of bhakti yoga after many, many births. That is also stated in the Bhagavad Gita. Bahunam janvanam ante, at the end of millions of births, jnani, jnanaban, those who are searching through knowledge. So what is the value of our knowledge? Teeny knowledge, imperfect senses. We are gathering imperfect knowledge. But we don't neglect knowledge. We give credit to the philosophers, scientists, because. But we advise them that your research work should be for God, not for any temporary physical or chemical compound. No. It is advised by Narad Muni, kovibhi nirupita idangi pungsas tapasas sutasva suktasya buddhasya buddhadatvaya avichito artha kovibhi nirupita jad uttama sloka gunanubarnanam. If you are a jnani, a philosopher, speculating what is the truth, so the truth is, ultimate truth is Krishna. So if from the very beginning you try to search out by your philosophical knowledge, or if you try to prove the supremacy of Krishna by your philosophical speculation, that is perfection. That is your perfection. Otherwise, it is simply laboring, waste of time. Sarmaeva hi kevalam. If you cannot go forward up to Krishna by your philosophical and scientific research, then all the labor you have taken, that is almost simply waste of time. The limit of knowledge, the limit of scientific research will be confirmed when you have surrender to God. Bhavanam janmanamanti jnanavan mang prapadyate vasudeva sarvamiti sa mahatma sudullava. That mahatma who knows Krishna is the supreme cause, govindam madhipurisam tamang maja. So our conclusion is there, that he is the supreme, govinda. So we bow down, yes. Govindam adipurisam tamang bhaja. We give all respects to others, but so far our surrendering process is concerned, that is to Krishna. Govindam adipurisam tamang bhaja. Under the direction of Lord Brahma. Therefore, here it is said, that janma guhyam bhagavato jaye tat prayata nara. Just like we are here in this Krishna consciousness moment, we don't claim that we have become perfect. That is not our... We cannot become perfect. Or at least we have not become perfect. But prayato, we are trying to be perfect. Prayata means endeavoring. Endeavoring for understanding God. So therefore here it is said, janma guhyam bhagavatu yap etat prayata nara. Any person who endeavors for understanding Krishna through the relative shastras and devotional service, then what is the reason? When sayang prata, two times at least, in the evening and in the morning. So if you sleep in the morning, snoring, then how we can understand? It is recommended here. Sayang prata, trisandha. Trisandha means three times. We initiate the promise that three times they chant Gayatri Mantra, but I do not know what they are doing. So these are the recommendations in the Shastra. If you don't follow, then we must fall down. There is no doubt about it. But if we follow the regulative principles as they are enjoined in the Shastra, Sadhu Guru Shastra, Shastra will say the same thing as Guru advises, Sadhu Guru. A saintly person also will say the same thing. Just like here, Sudha Goswami, he is a saintly person. He is advising, Sayang Prata, morning and evening. You should try to understand the science of God. Bhagavad Gita, Srimad Bhagavatam, topics, chanting. So these are the process. Sayang Prata Grinan Bhaktya. Now this is the most important word. Bhaktya. Because without bhakti, the real process is bhakti. Bhaktya mam abhijanati, Bhagavad Gita said. Here also it is said that don't read just like an academic scholar. No, that will not benefit you. It will benefit you, but it will take long, long time. Because without bhakti, God cannot be captured. Without bhakti, God cannot be captured. Everywhere you will find that. Krishna says in the Bhagavad Gita, Jomi bhaktya prajacchati, patram puspam phalam toyam jomi bhaktya prajacchati. Patram, a little flower, little leaf. Suppose I am very poor man. I cannot arrange for puri and rasgulla for Krishna. But then what my offering will be? No, there is no opportunity for offering Krishna. No, Krishna says, you can offer me a little flower, a little leaf, little water, that's all. Who cannot secure it? Any part of the world, anywhere, a person can offer to Krishna, sir, I have no means, I have secured these things. The Krishna says, yes, that's all right. Patram puspam phalam toyam jome bhaktya prajacchati. This bhakta. One who offers me in devotion and love, that is the main ingredient. And a non-devotee cannot offer anything, Krishna. Krishna is not poor. Krishna has not come here. He is very hungry. He come here to eat your puri and rasgulla. Don't think like that. But Krishna is so kind that he has come before you to accept whatever you can offer with devotion. That is it.